Hello friends, myself Amruta Pokhare from Atharva College of Engineering from INFT department. The course I am running is Computer Simulation and Modeling. This lecture topic is to understand an example to simulate a real world system problem. Okay, so let's start with the lecture. I will like to share my screen first. Just a second. I hope you all are able to see my screen. Okay, then let me move ahead. Okay, so before starting the example, before trying to understand how to simulate a particular problem, first let's understand what do you mean by simulation itself. Okay, so I hope you can see the screen. Here there is a definition of simulation. Now what do you mean by simulation? A simulation is the imitation of the operation of a real-world process or a system over time. So what it is, what is simulation is basically, in other words, if I say, let's consider simulation as a software model which we have developed for a real-world working system. For example, let me take the same example which we are going to solve today, that is grocery store. So grocery store is a real world system problem. We will try to develop a software model in order to understand the working of the grocery store. So I hope you have got the definition of simulation. Okay, what? So why we are doing simulation? In order to develop the assumptions about mathematical, logical and symbolic relations between the entities in that system. Okay, so in case of grocery store, we are trying to understand what all are the entities, what are the relation between that entities, what are mathematical logical operations are getting performed with that entities and so on. This all conclusions can be drawn out with the help of simulation. Okay. What next line says, it is to estimate the measures of performance of the system. So obviously with the help of simulation, we will be able to draw different performance measures, right? And with the help of performance measure, how it is going to help us out? Obviously, with the help of performance measures, various values, we will be able to analyze our system and make different conclusions whether the system is working properly or not, what all changes are required or no changes are required in the system. Oh, if we add some new things to it, then how the system will react. So all this stuff can be drawn out with the help of simulation. I hope you all are getting the importance of simulation. Okay, so now when simulation model can be used? One, it can be used as an analysis tool or it can be used as a designing tool. Are you getting? If it is an existing system, you can use it just to analyze that system. Okay, analyze the different effect of changes on that system, right? And if it is a new system to be developed, then it can be used as a designing tool. For example, in case of new system, I will say, let's say you are trying to develop an aeroplane. Okay, so you will not directly start developing an aeroplane, right? You will develop a simulation model, right? And you will try to understand the working of that airplane system, and later on you will implement that model once you are sure it will work properly. So this was an example of new system as a designing tool. Okay, and in case of your grocery store, it is an existing system, you're just trying to analyze it and you are trying to understand that system or you can like any proposal has been made in your existing system, in any business you can consider, and a new proposal has been made that and different changes can help you to grow the business. So before just implementing that changes, what you can do is you can develop a simulation model, analyze the model, understand how the changes are affecting our system, and if they are affecting in a good way, you can go for implementing it in the existing system. Okay, I hope it is clear. Let me move to the example directly. So today we are going to simulate a grocery store system. Now, grocery store system is nothing but a single channel queuing system. Now, how this queuing system works is there is one or more. Now, I'm saying it is a single channel queuing system, so there is, will be a single server. If it's multi-channel, then multiple servers can be there. So, in case of grocery store, let's consider there is one person who is serving. So, one server is there. There is n number of calling population, infinite calling population. Okay, and how customers are coming? Let's consider they are coming in a queue. So from calling population, one by one the customer will come. They will wait in a queue, and the server will serve them one at a time. Right. So they will arrive in first come first serve basis. Right. So this is nothing but a image of a queuing system, single channel queuing system. Okay, fine. Let's move to the example directly. Now you all are clear with queuing system working, right? Okay. Let me jump to the problem. Okay. Let's see the problem statement. Here is the problem statement. What does the problem statement say? A small grocery store has only one checkout counter. Okay, what does it mean? There is a grocery store and it is having only one person to serve. Okay. Customers arrive at this checkout counter at random from 1 to 8 minutes apart. So customers are arriving and the time between that customers is divided between 1 to 8 minutes. Okay. It is shown in the table. The table for the same is provided. Okay, so time between arrival distribution is provided and the distribution is between 1 to 8 minutes. Okay, so each possible value of inter-arrival time, which is nothing but time between arrival, has the same probability of occurrence. Okay, so probability of occurrence of the customer is same. Okay, you can see over here. This two tables are provided to you. Only first two columns are given to you from both the tables. Okay, so time between arrival is divided between 1 to 8 minutes apart. Customers time between arrival is divided between 1 to 8 minutes. Okay, and the probability is same as they said in the problem statement. Okay, the probability of occurrence of a customer is same. That is 0.125. Okay, here they are saying the service time varies from 1 to 6 minutes apart. So this is also given to you. Service time varies from 1 to 6 minutes apart. With the probability shown in the given table. The problem is to analyze the system by simulating the arrival and service of 20 customers. So here, as per the problem statement, we are just trying to simulate the single channel queuing system, that is a grocery store, for 20 customers, for 20 arrivals. Here, we are just analyzing the system area. Can I start then? So as I said, these two tables are provided. In these two tables, the first two columns are given to you, right? Okay, you have to generate the next two columns. Okay, let's start. Now you have time between arrival and its probability is given. You have to generate the cumulative probability and random digit assignment. Okay. So how to generate the cumulative probability? Most of you all must be knowing it. Let's see it. So your first cumulative probability will be same as your probability. Fine. The next cumulative probability will be the addition of previous cumulative probability and the current probability. Correct? So 0.125 added with 0.125, right, will give you 0.250. Right? Next cumulative probability, how it is drawn? 0.375. How it has arrived? The previous cumulative probability added with the current probability will give you 0.37, and procedure goes on. Finally, you will get the cumulative probability as 1. If you get 1, that means your calculation has been done properly. Okay. Now, how to find out the random digit assignment? Random digit. With the help of cumulative probability, we can find the range of random digits. Why? Because we have, as the problem statement says, randomly the customers are arriving. So, we are trying to find the random digit range. Okay, with the help of cumulative probability. Okay, the number is start, first number range will start from 1, obviously, right? It is going till 125. Right? How? If you will consider this cumulative probability and you will multiply it with 1000, you will get 125. So, first range is going from 1 to 125. Next is 125 plus 1, that is 126. 126. I hope the screen is visible. Let me maximize it. Okay. So the range is going from 1 to 125, then 126 to 250, 251 to 375, and so on. So last is 1000. So random digit range is going from 1 to 1000. The last three digits have been shown. 000. Fine. Clear with the distribution table of time between arrival, how to generate cumulative probability and random digit assignment. Now service time distribution. In same way we can generate the cumulative probability. First will be same as the probability, right? Second will be addition of previous plus the current probability, right? Will give you 0.37. So last, if you are getting answer as 1, the calculation is done properly, right? Now random digit assignment: 1 to 10, 11 to 11 kaise aaya, 10 plus 1, so 11 to 30, 31 to 60, and so on, right? Okay, so we're done with the first two tables. Your third table is time between arrival determination. We are trying to generate a time between arrival for each customer now. So what all columns will be there in this table? Three columns: customer, random digits, and time between arrival. Okay. So how many customers? 1 to 20. Right. Random, we have to assign the random digits now. How to assign it? From the previous table, as we know, the range is going from 1 to 1000. So, between 1 to 1000, you can assign any random digit to your customers. Right? As we can see, there is no random digit assigned for the first customer. Why? Can anyone think upon it? See, we are trying to generate the time between arrival. What do you mean by time between arrival? Time between arrival is nothing but a time between two customers, right? First or second customer ke beech ka time, matlab time between arrival. So obviously, first customer ke pehle koi customer nahi hai. So no need to assign any random digit for the first customer, right? So there will be no time between arrival for the first customer, as there is no customer before. Okay, so we have assigned randomly some random digits between 1 to 1000, and we have generated time between arrival. How? You have to see 913 in your first table. Where 913 is falling here? 913 is falling over here. So the time between arrival will be 8 for the second customer. Correct. 27. See this random digit in your first table. 727 is falling under this range. So your time between arrival will be 6. Alright, and so on. Similarly, you can randomly assign this time between arrival to these customers with the help of random digits. And how to decide a range of random digits? From first table, which is going from 1 to 1000. Clear. Now, third table is done. Fourth table is service time generation. Now, with the help of second table, we are trying to generate the fourth table, that is service time generation. Similar columns, customer, random digits, and service time in minutes. Okay, now here we have provided the random digits for first customer because obviously first customer will take some service time, right? So we have to assign the random digit for the first customer. Okay. So what will be the range of this random digit? You can see it from here. Second table, it is going from 1 to 100, right? So 1 to 100 ke beech mein hame random digits assign kar liye. For 84, what will be the service time for first customer? 84 is falling over here, so service time is 4. Ten, where it is falling in this range, so service time is 1. Right, and so on. You can find the service time. Then so on, you can assign the service time to all the customers. Right. Now this is your final simulation table. Okay. Just a second. Let me check the time. Still, I have 12 minutes, no problem. Okay, so your final simulation table, what all columns are there in your final simulation table? Customer, first column, obviously it will be customer, going from 1 to 20, 20 customers. Next column is time since last arrival, that is your time between arrival. Where you have drawn the time between arrival? In the third table, right? The same values, you have to copy it in your final simulation table. वहाँ से same values उठा के यहाँ पे लिख दो क्योंकि हमने already time between arrival generate कर चुके हैं हम लोग third table में, right? अभी with the help of this time between arrival, we will generate the arrival time. That will be our third column. How to generate the arrival time? For first customer, it will obviously start from 0 time. Okay. So, first arrival time will be 0. Second arrival time will be addition of first arrival plus the time between arrival. Between 1 and 2. Right. It's normal common sense logic. Agar pehle customer ka arrival time 0 hai, to second customer ka arrival time kya hoga? 0 plus the time between arrival of between these two customers, right? So 0 plus 8 will give you 8. Now arrival time of third customer will be previous arrival plus the time between arrival will give you the current arrival, right? 8 plus 6 is 14 and so on. You can find the other arrival times, right? Okay. So, how to generate arrival time is clear. Okay. Now the fourth column is service time. Have you all generated the service time? Yes, we have. We have done it during the calculation of fourth table. We have already randomly assigned the service time to all the customers, right? So, same values, you copied it down over here, service time. Okay. Now, here the actual simulation goes. Next column is time service begin. Just a second. Time service begin and time service end. Okay. In center it is, the column is time customer waiting in queue. Okay, so time service begin for first customer will be obviously 0. It is arriving at 0. So time service begin, as the server is free, the begin time for the first customer will be 0. Is he waiting? No, obviously. So 0. What will be the time service end for first customer? It will be addition of time service begin plus the service time. So 0 plus 4 will provide you the end time of the service. Correct? Okay. Now what will be the next time service begin? The second customer is arriving at 8. Correct? And the previous customer is leaving the system at 4. So, as soon as the second customer arrives, it will start getting the service, as the server is getting free at 4 itself, right? So, the time service begin for second customer will be 8. That is the arrival time of it. Correct? Is a customer waiting? No. So, 0 is the waiting time. What will be end time? 8 plus the service time. Begin time plus the service time. That is 9. Okay. What will be the begin time of next customer? It is arriving at 14. Previous customer is leaving the system at 9. So, the begin time will be as per the arrival time of third customer. So, 14. 14 plus 4 will give you the end time. Okay. Now, we'll see. The fourth customer is arriving at 15. But the server, there is only one server and the server is getting free at 80, right? So once the server is free, then only then it can start the service. So even if the customer is arriving at 15, the time service begin will not be 15, right? It will be 18. So even if it is arriving at 15, the time service begin will be 18. That is the end time of the previous. I hope you all are getting. Okay. So what will be the waiting time? Obviously, 18 minus 15 will give you 3. 3 is the waiting time in queue for fourth customer. And similarly, you can calculate for the later values. Okay. Now, last two columns, time customer spend in system. What do you mean by time customer spends in system? The total time the customer is spending in the system, right? How much time the customer is spending in the system, how you can get it? Waiting time plus the service time is nothing but a time in system. Either the customer is waiting or the customer is getting served. So 0 plus 4 will give you the time in the system. That is 4, right? 6. 0 plus 1 is the time in system for that customer. 0 plus 4 is the time the customer spends in system, right? Waiting time 3 plus the service time 3 will give you the total time of that customer. Total time the customer spending in the system, that is 6. Are you hearing? Similarly, you can find out the time customer spends in system. Now, idle time of server. How you will find it out? Idle time of server. Kitna time server free tha? Khali tha. For first case, it will be obviously 0. What about second? It was idle for 4 minutes. How? Previous customer, first customer was leaving the system at 4. Next customer was arriving at 8. So, for 4 minutes, server was idle. Right? Server was not providing any services. So, idle time of server for second customer will be 4. Idle time of server for third customer case, the service was ending at 9, but next customer service was starting at 14. So 5 minutes server was free. So idle time of server will be 5, right? And similarly, you can calculate later values. Correct? So in this way, you can get the final simulation table. How much time do I have? I have 5 minutes. Good. Okay. So, are we done with the simulation? Yes, we are done with the simulation. Right? But is this much thing okay for us? No. We have to find the performance measures, as we said, right, in the definition. So how to find the performance measures? What are the n number of performance measures can be drawn out from this simulation, right? Okay. What all performance measures can be drawn out? Let's see over here. If you wish to find the average waiting time of the customer, what will be the average waiting time of the customer? It will be total time customer waiting in queue upon the total number of customers, right? So how much time the customer is waiting in queue, the total time customer waiting in queue? How to find out? From the time customer waiting in queue column, if you do the addition, you'll get the total time customer waiting in queue, right? That is 56. So 56 upon total number of customers, that is 20, will give you 2.8 minutes. So average waiting time for each customer is 2.8, right? Similarly, you can find n number of measures out of this simulation. If I'm trying to find out the probability that the customer will wait in queue, what, how to draw it? The number of customers waiting in queue upon the total number of customers. So number of customers waiting in queue, kitne hai customers those are waiting in queue, again from same column you can find it out, right? Yahan pe 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 10 11 12 13 total 13 customers are waiting in queue. So 13 upon 20 will give you the probability of customer waiting in queue. Correct. If you wish to find out the probability of idle time of server, it will be the total idle time of server upon the total runtime of the simulation. So total idle time of server kaise milega? Last column ka addition is the total idle time of servers. 18 minutes server was idle, right? So 18 upon 86 is the total simulation time. Kaise mila 86? From here, time service end, the final last time, last customer ka end time is nothing but the total time of the simulation, right? That is 86. So Eighteen upon 86 will give you 0.21. Is that is the probability of idle time of server. I hope you have enjoyed this lecture. Similarly, you can draw various n number of measures, right? N number of measures can be drawn from this simulation.